Today we got to finish up this house. We're going to add windows, doors, and a garage door, and then we're going to get this thing ready to be printed. Welcome back to the Civil Guide channel. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button and the like button and leave a comment down below. Let me know what you think. If you have any questions, leave it down below and I will try to get back to you. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and get started. This is where we left off last time. Go to insert, hit cube, just like before. And we're gonna drag this to the front. And we're gonna shrink this down. We have to exaggerate all the features since this is gonna be smaller than the palm of my hand. With this garage door here, I'm going to bring this in. Bring this in just like that. It's gonna be very simple. Nothing too crazy, nothing too elaborate. I'm just gonna bring this up just like that. And as a matter of fact, I'm gonna duplicate this object. And then what I'm gonna do is extend this out just a teeny bit, just like that. I'm gonna bring the section that I copied, overlap it with the previous object, scale it down. I'm gonna have to adjust it this way and adjust it that way. Yeah, it's looking pretty good. I'm gonna turn on the X-ray mode so I can actually see through everything. And I'm going to subtract. Now we have a little bit of a molding going around the edge of the garage door. Don't want to make the garage door too wide because I think that's just gonna be a waste of plastic. Us here at Civil Guy Studios, we do not want to waste plastic, no. We're in the business of saving plastic. The garage door is looking pretty nice. I'm gonna add a little pattern to it. And I want this to be a two-door garage. So this is like the halfway point. I'm gonna add another one of these right here. And I'll add one, whoops. I wanna do it along this axis. There we go. We're gonna copy this again. I'm gonna rotate this. I'm gonna scale this up, rotate it. There we go. Okay, click on object mirror. There we go, copy and paste. Yeah, I know, I realize it looks like a barn door style garage door, but we're gonna pretend this ranch style home is out in the middle of the country. So right now, let's go ahead and add some windows. Same thing, add an object. And just like the garage door, we're gonna add a little frame. We're gonna copy, shrink it this way, shrink it this way, shrink it this way, and then, yeah, I like that. And before I actually subtract that, I'm just gonna duplicate that object. I was supposed to fix this window in the last video, but I did not do that because I was too busy trying to make sure the video was under, I think, it was, what was it, 11 minutes? This should fix that window, kinda. I'm gonna select everything just like this. Then what I'm gonna do is just copy and paste it to the other side. All right, there we go. Now what we have to do is group it, select it, subtract it. All right, so right now we have all the frames put in, except for the door frame. I guess I can go ahead and do that now as well. I don't know, guys. Today seems like a very odd day. Like, I feel a little out of it, but at the same time, I'm still trucking along, so it's kind of weird. Maybe it's because it's election season. Okie dokie, so we have the door almost done. I just gotta subtract the door frame. Now, since we're printing this out, we gotta make sure, again, I don't know how many times I have to say this, we have to be aware of how thick the walls are for the window frame. It might look a little weird here in the software, but I'm doing this for a reason. All right, we're just gonna keep the window very simple. Just have one little line going across it, just like that. We're gonna do the same for the next window right here. We're done with the windows. Now all we have to do is add the door. How are we gonna do the door? Well, I'm glad you asked. We're gonna scale it down, drop it in there just like that. That's our little door, guys. I would add some more patterns to it. Heck, why not? Let's go ahead and add a little pattern. We'll add a little line to it. It looks like a nice southern home, I guess. Okay, so right now we're missing something. We're missing some shutters. Let's add some shutters real quickly. We don't have to add it to the back because who puts shutters in the back of their house? Who does that? All right, we're just gonna bring this up just like that. Copy, paste. And you can just tell that we're just using, you know, estimation. We're not doing anything too crazy, too elaborate. All right, so we got our nice looking house there. Let's add a little vent right here, shall we? So let's insert an object again. We're gonna click on the cylinder this time. Rotate it 90 degrees this way. We're gonna scale it down, center it right there. So what I want to do is add some of those little air flaps, whatever you call it. All right, we pretty much have the exterior part of the house done. I'm going to repaint everything again to that black color. To make this easier, I'm just going to choose a material. Listen, if I had some more time, I'd probably add some more detail to it. And what I would typically do is possibly add siding or some, maybe some bricks to the walls. And then also some shingling to the roof. But I don't have time for that right now. In our next video, what we're going to do is actually print this out. So stay tuned for that. We'll see how this turns out. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully you learned something. And if you did, let me know about it. Leave a comment down below. I would love to hear what you have to say about this. This is a very fun project. Probably going to take a break from the series, but I'm going to get back into it at some point